we start new article. Magnetic induction at a point on axis of the coil carrying current. So we consider circular loop of radius A. Carrying current I. P be the axial point at a distance x. You can see here it is axial point P, which is at a distance x from the center O. Now we imagine that coil is divided into number of small elements. One of the such element is at point A, and due to this length element, magnetic induction at point P we have to find out, and it is given by Biot-Savart law. So mu 0 upon 4 pi idl sin 90 divided by r square. So we get magnetic induction due to this length element which is present at point A, and this is dB. This magnetic induction is represented by this arrow. You can see here this arrow. So here written arrow PC, or otherwise this is the magnetic induction due to this length. Now it is resolved, this magnetic induction having two component, or it is resolved into two component, dB cos phi. You can see here this is the first component, dB cos phi. Second component is dB sin phi. So dB sin phi is the second component. And this magnetic induction dB is resolved into two components, dB cos phi and dB sin phi. You can see in a diagram. Now, magnetic induction at point P due to diametrically opposite small element which is present at point B. So I consider at point B a small element is there, and due to that element magnetic induction again given by same formula. And in a diagram you can see here it is written by dB dash, but the distance is same, everything is same, so we can write dB also. So dB again it is resolved into two components. So dB sin phi and dB cos phi. Okay. So here in a diagram we have written dB dash. So you can use dB or dB dash. Okay. So you can see here this, it is resolved into two components, dB cos phi and dB sin phi. Now here this perpendicular component, this perpendicular components dB cos phi cancel each other. Means this dB cos phi and this dB cos phi, they are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, so they cancel with each other. So magnetic induction at point P is due to this dB sin phi and this dB sin phi. We consider two elements, so that's why 2 dB sin phi we get. So total magnetic induction at point P due to this current carrying coil is given by integration of this dB sin phi. So this is the formula. You can see. Now let me substitute here the value of dB. So dB is mu 0 by 4 pi idl divided by r square, and this sin phi we have written as it is. Now from figure, sin phi is, sin phi is given by A upon root x square plus A square. You can see in a diagram again, sin phi, sine of this angle phi, this is a phi. So sin phi is equal to opposite side, it is A divided by hypotenuse is R. Or by Pythagoras, if it is x, this is A, then this R is under root A square plus x square. So instead of this R, we can write under root A square plus x square by using Pythagoras. Again, this sin phi we substituted. So you can see here, this A divided by under root x square plus a square is the sine phi. As well as I just shown you in the diagram, small r is root x square plus a square. So r square is what? X square plus a square. This formula we get. So total magnetic induction is equal to, so we take the constant outside, mu 0 I, this a is constant, divided by 4 pi is constant, this a, x square plus a square is constant. Now here, we can see here, it is x square plus a square raised to 1 multiplied by root of x square plus a square, means it is raised to 1 by 2. So it is coming x square plus a square raised to 3 by 2. So it is written here. Can see here, x square plus a square raised to 3 by 2. Now here, integration of dl. So dl is a small length element of this circular pipe. So integration of dl gives us circumference of the pipe. Circumference is given by formula 2 pi into radius. But here radius of the coil we consider a, so circumference is 2 pi. Now integration of dl we substitute 2 pi a. Now after simplifying this, we get this pi, pi get cancelled, and these 2's are 4. So we get mu 0 I, and this a square we get, divided by 2 in a bracket x square plus a square raised to 3 by 2. And this is expression for magnetic induction at axial point. But if you consider the coil having n number of turns, then the formula we get mu 0 n I a square divided by 2 x square plus a square raised to 3 by 2. So this is the final expression for magnetic induction at the axial point of current carrying coil. These are the special cases. Since if x is 0, means point is at the center, we get magnetic induction this. And if we consider x is at very, very large distance, then this term nearly equal to x cube, and we get magnetic induction given by this formula. A circular loop of radius 9.7 centimeter carries a current 2.3 ampere. Obtain the magnitude of magnetic field. The first point is at the center of the loop, and second point is at a distance 9.7 from the center of the loop on its axis. Since here both the formulas we have to use, at the center and at axial point. So let's see here the given. A is 9.7 centimeter. It is converted into meter. So x is 9.7 centimeter again. So it is converted into meter. Current is 2.3 ampere. Now at the center of the current carrying coil, magnetic induction is given by this formula. Now here you can write A. So because in a given we have written this as a A. After substitution of mu 0 I 2 and means this radius, we get this, and the calculation for the magnetic induction is coming this 1.489 into 10 raised to minus 5 tesla, or you can use the unit Weber per meter square. Now when we consider this point is axial point, which is at a distance 9.7. And here you note one thing here, x and a both are same. Because in a formula, x square plus a square bracket raised to 3 by 2 is there. So x square plus a square we can write 2 into, both are same, x and a both are same. So we can write 2 into 9.7 into 10 raised to minus 2 square. So it is meter square. Now we substitute this value in a formula of magnetic induction. So this is the magnetic induction formula. So mu 0, you know that 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7. I, the current 2.3 ampere. let me substitute all the values. So after substitution we get this, and this calculation you have to do. After doing this calculation we get the final answer for this question is 5.265 into 10 raised to minus 6 tesla.